was white, and he was very much opposed to people seeing these images, images being shown. And I felt the opposite. And we both were coming to that from a place of kind of what is ethical. And I felt like if you've seen that documentary, Beyond Sanctuary, or if you haven't, you can go to the website, which is a documentary about lynching in America. Those images began as greeting cards. The most depraved, horrendous, inhuman kinds of behavior that people were sending to each other as notes, like, you know, I witnessed this. And at the same time, if we didn't have access to those cards, we wouldn't have a document to establish this is what happened to us. And as a historian, everything is about documents. It's about what you can prove. And I do feel like at the same time, there is a secondary trauma to us seeing these images again and again and again. And that's for people to make their personal decisions about about how they grapple with that, or how much of that you can take. I'll just be honest with you, I didn't come in because I couldn't watch this film twice in a row. I just saw it and I was like, I can't do that again. And so that was just me, my own kind of self-care version of this. But I do think that we have to, for better or worse, we wouldn't be having this conversation though without those images, because people would say, like the old Richard Pryor joke when he was talking about police violence, and that he kind of mimicked the white person saying, oh, those people were resisting arrest, you know? Well, now you can see, no, this person had their hands up and they were shot, and they weren't doing anything that warranted being shot. And I think it's an uncomfortable reality, but we have to grapple with that. And the last thing I'll say, I do want to close on this note, is that one of the things about this film is that like, I lived through the 90s, I'm a native New Yorker. I remember what it was like here at that point in time. I went to school in Washington, D.C., at the point at which it was the murder capital of the United States. I've had people pull guns on me more times than I can count. Police and people who were not police. And there is some relationship between you know, the former and the latter. And what I think is what concerns me is that we're at a point now where we can have this conversation. Crime is historically low. And we're reckoning with what we turned to. In the same way, like after 9/11, we gave the government a blanket authority to do anything that it wanted. And it took more than a decade for us to actually say, wait, what they're doing in the name of protecting us, is this actually warranted? And to begin to ask those questions. And what worries me, I think, is that for us to have this conversation now is one thing, but if we were to confront the same sorts of social problems, would we turn to a similar solution 5 years from now? And so I hope that we can think about this film in a really educational way to say that we have to confront these problems, which are complex and difficult, but simply throwing up our hands and saying that we give you carte blanche to do anything in the name of protecting us is fundamentally not the way a democracy ever operates. So, thank you.
Thank you all so much. I really appreciate that. Thank you for the Netflix.